All right. Baltimore. We got to talk, man. Tomorrow's the day, man. Week 17. Everything's on the table, man. This is it. Season on the line right here. Win or go home. If you win, you're going to the playoffs. If you lose, the season ends in disappointment. It's time to get the job done. And I know you guys are going to, because I believe in you, okay? All week, you've been spreading this message of how focused and locked in the team is. You've got the message of finish. Finish, finish, finish. You've got to finish the season off right. You've got to be focused. You cannot take this team lightly. That message has been spread around the team all week. So I believe they're going to be locked in. But you got to still take care of business. You can say you're locked in, and you can say you're focused on finishing, but at the end of the day, if you go out there and you fail to deliver on that, you can only blame yourselves. So guys, you got to get it done. This is definitely somebody we're used to. Cincinnati, man. Funny enough, Cincinnati actually ended our playoff chances twice. They've ended our season twice in the 2010s. Obviously, we know the infamous 4th and 12 that happened in 2017. But they also ended our season back in 2013. You know, after the Super Bowl, we had our struggles because a lot of players ended up leaving the team. And we also dealt with some injuries. Heck, Flacco even dealt with some injuries. And, you know, we had an opportunity to possibly make the playoffs and give ourselves an opportunity. But we ended up losing to the Cincinnati Bengals. And that pretty much ended our season. That's how we ended up 8-8 for the most part. So Cincinnati has actually done a great job keeping us out of the postseason when we're in week 17, got to win this game to give ourselves an opportunity to go to the playoffs. They've done a great job with that. And the funny thing about that 2017 game is that I'm not 100% sure the franchise actually gets Lamar Jackson if we do go to the playoffs. Now, Lamar Jackson probably would have kept dropping in the draft, but I don't know if the organization would have looked to even taken an opportunity. Even if he dropped in the second round, I'm not sure they would have looked to trade it up to even get him. Because obviously with their first round pick, they spent on Hayden Hurts. That was a tight end for Flacco for the most part. They didn't really show like they had any signs of possibly getting Lamar Jackson. And maybe they did. Obviously they traded up to get him. That's probably the case. But if we win that game against Cincinnati, is that even a conversation? A lot of us believe that had we won that game and gone to the playoffs, no matter what the results of the playoffs would have been, the organization would have been like, you know what, we got to the playoffs this year, we just have to add more pieces for Flacco. I don't think they look for another quarterback. But for the fact that we lost that game and we ended up missing the playoffs 3 straight years, that probably puts something in the organization that's like, Flacco might be slipping. He might be slipping. It may be time to look for somebody else. Even if that's not our main priority, if somebody drops to us, we got to take an opportunity to get him. And that ended up being the case with Lamar Jackson. Now, obviously, they didn't see him becoming what he became this early. Honestly, if we think about it, this season should have been Lamar's rookie season because everyone was like, he's going to be behind Flacco for 2 years and then he's going to take over. Instead, he got thrown into the fire, handled it like a professional, did what he needed to do, led the team to the playoffs, and he became the face of the franchise. Last year ended up becoming league MVP. So we know what Lamar is doing. And then this year, he's one win away from taking the team to the playoffs for the 3rd straight year. So everything worked out. But still, with this game against Cincinnati, you cannot undermine them. This is definitely a team that they've been heating up the last couple of weeks. They've actually won 2 straight games, and they've been known to ruin our season. So we've got to be focused. We've got to be disciplined. We've got to win this game no matter what. It's going to be tough. It's definitely going to be tough. And I know some people will be like, it's the Cincinnati Bengals. It's the Cincinnati Bengals. Well, no, it's just not the Cincinnati Bengals. Previous history shows that we've lost against them. However, I will say this, that definitely helps in our favor. Flacco was historically bad against Cincinnati. No, like, honestly, you look at that. When you look at the AFC North, there was no other defense that had Flacco's number better than Cincinnati. When he played Pittsburgh, they definitely gave him fits and problems. That's just the rivalry there. Cleveland didn't really give him fits like that because I think he lost maybe 2 games to Cleveland his entire time there. Though Cleveland never had the talent they have this year. So it is what it is. But with Cincinnati, they've always given him fits. We've always struggled to beat Cincinnati, and that's always been a problem. And not to mention with our defense, we've never really been able to figure out AJ Green when he was healthy and doing his thing back in his prime. Of course, he's still in his prime now, but like He just seems like a shell of himself right now. So it's insane. But like Cincinnati always had Flacco's number. Well, Lamar Jackson is different. Lamar has never lost to Cincinnati. And this feels like a game that's setting him up. But like, hopefully it's not going to be the case. Lamar has never lost against Cincinnati in his entire career. Played them his rookie season once, beat them, swept them last year, beat them again this year. And he has the opportunity to sweep them again. Cincinnati has never beaten Lamar Jackson. They have yet to really figure out how to stop or contain this man. Even though he didn't really have a good game against Cincinnati back in, what was it, week 5? We still ended up beating them like 27-3. It was 27. It was basically 27-0. That field goal does not count. So, yeah, the team pretty much knew what they were doing. And I'll say this again. Under Lamar Jackson, when we're favored by double digits in the regular season, we don't lose those type of games. The one game we were favored by double digits was against the Titans. We lost that game. But in the regular season, when we're favored by double digits, we usually get the job done. If we're favored to beat somebody big, we usually beat somebody big. You know, we just do it. We did it with the Giants. We beat them by 14. We blew out the Jags and we blew out the Cowboys. We were expected to beat them by big numbers, and we did. So that's definitely great to know that we can do that under Lamar Jackson. When it comes to games we're expected to win, we can win those games. So that's definitely a positive. But of course, you know, since this game here definitely holds a lot of value, not only because it's like a Week 17 game, but also people are telling me this, it's a January game. And Lamar Jackson can't win games in January. You know that. So obviously people are like, he's going to choke. He can't win games in January. So yeah, people would not be surprised if the Ravens end up losing this game. I'll personally be shocked if that happens. You will see. We missed the playoffs, man. I don't even know. I don't even want to put that in my mind. Like, nah. I need some, like, Hold on. I know I got something there. Give me a second. I need it. I got to knock on some wood. Because there's no way we lose in this game, man. I can't be in the reality. This can't be the reality where it happens. Maybe another reality, just not this reality. Please don't let it be this reality. But yeah, we just got to get the job done. And at the end of the day, this has been a chaotic season for the Ravens. You came into the season with Super Bowl aspirations. You were one of the best teams coming into the season. And unfortunately, it didn't work out the way you wanted it to. Okay, injuries started to pile up. We lost some guys and we dealt with the whole outbreak. You ended up losing games you shouldn't have lost. You had a lead against the Pittsburgh Steelers and you were running the football. You don't lose those type of games. In fact, we closed those type of games. You had a lead against Tennessee, and you were running the football. You shouldn't have lost that game, too. Both of those were home games. You had the lead, and you had the ball in your hands, and somehow we ended up losing those games. That doesn't happen. That's not supposed to happen under Lamar Jackson. We've never really had those type of issues in the past. If we're up against them, and we're running the football effectively, that's game. But we haven't been able to close games against these teams for the most part. Now, granted, we did have a moment where we were finally able to close a game, and that was against Cleveland, who was a good team. They're also fighting for their playoff lives tomorrow against Pittsburgh. So we're starting to heat up at the right moment, and that's a good thing because, you know, at the end of the day, no matter what happens, as long as you get in the tournament, anything can happen. Let's not forget the 9-7 Giants went on to win a Super Bowl, and in one of those games, in the divisional round, they beat the 15-1 Green Bay Packers that were coming off of a Super Bowl championship, and Aaron Rodgers was the MVP. So it's possible. Hell, us, we won our division in our Super Bowl year, and we had to play in the wild card round. We beat the Colts, went on the road to Denver to beat Peyton Manning, went into New England to beat Tom Brady, and we got to the Super Bowl and win. That's just how it is. Just because you're not the number one seed doesn't necessarily mean you can't get to the Super Bowl. Obviously, the Chiefs are favored. No question the Chiefs are favored. Obviously, the Bills, if we match up against them, they're going to be favored. They've been the better team this year. But it doesn't mean we can't beat them. It's possible to go on the run in the postseason. It's happened plenty of times. Why can't it happen to us this year? If everybody gets healthy and we continue to play the way we're playing football and we continue to be disciplined and not turn over the ball like we've been doing in these losses, because we look back at that Pittsburgh loss, 4 turnovers from Lamar, unacceptable. If we don't turn the ball over, we can beat any team in the league. If we don't turn the ball over, if we're disciplined and we're playing our game and everybody's healthy, we can beat any team in the league. Even Kansas City. We just haven't been able to do that. So, because there's a clear difference between being able to and actually going out and doing it. So, will the Ravens be able to pull that off? We'll find out if they make the playoffs. It all starts with this game. You got to get the job done. So, we're going to see what happens tomorrow. If the Ravens punch their ticket into the postseason and everybody can get in healthy, at that point, we can focus on whoever our first opponent is. Whether it's the Bills, Steelers, or Titans, we got to be ready to go. No matter what. most likely, I don't know, unless if the Dolphins win, we're going up against Pittsburgh right off the bat. If the Dolphins lose and we win, no matter what, if we win, as long as we win, we're going to be a fifth seed or a sixth seed. If we lose, then you need some help there, and you could potentially be a seventh seed. But most likely, if Baltimore wins and punches their ticket to the playoffs, they're either facing off against the Titans or the Steelers in the first round. One of the two. We'll see what happens. But you can't talk about the playoffs until you actually make the playoffs. Week 17 is coming down to the wire. A lot of teams fighting for their playoff hopes. We're one of them. Get the job done, Baltimore. Punch your ticket into the playoffs, and let's see what happens. With that being said, that's all I got for you. We're going to see what happens tomorrow. It should be fantastic. With that being said, guys, I'm out of here. I'll see you tomorrow, and hopefully the Ravens win this game. Peace.